Many in the Seventh-day Adventist Church are unaware of this, but the SDA Church has compiled their own version of Testimonies for the Church, as well as other books, so as to prevent the truth from getting out regarding their wicked ways. Notice what we see here in the E.G. White Estate DVD. In both their 1904 version of the Testimonies and their 1983 book titled The Publishing Ministry, a certain rebuke and warning has been removed. I will only read one of these quotes, as they are identical. In their version of the Testimonies, Volume 8, page 91, it says, "I feel a terror of soul as I see to what a pass our publishing house has come. The presses in the Lord's institution have been printing the soul-destroying theories of Romanism and other mysteries of iniquity." And they ended it there. Well, as is obvious, Sister White was very concerned with what they were doing with her writings at that time. But then this was after the church's direct rejection of Christ in 1888, and so it was to be expected. They left something out in this quote, however, that I am sure many will see is very telling. And when I read it to you, many are going to understand why they removed it, especially those that left the church during the exodus of the 1980s. Notice this open rebuke to the managers of the Review and Herald, which was later added to her original version of the Testimonies, Volume 8. You can also find this quote intact in pamphlet number 151 on page 20 under the title, A Solemn Warning. She said, "I feel a terror of soul, and I see to what a pass our publishing house has come. The presses in the Lord's institution have been printing the soul-destroying theories of Romanism and other mysteries of iniquity." Well, that's where they ended it previously. Everything I'm going to read now has been removed. She goes on to say that this is taking all sacredness from the office. The managers are loading the guns of the enemy and placing them in their hands to be used against the truth. How does God regard such work? In the books of heaven are written the words, unfaithful stewardship. Thus, God regards the publication of matter which comes from Satan's manufactory, his hellish scientific delusions. What they did here shows the same evil spirit was at work again that moved them to remove the first 12 pages of A Word to a Little Flock, as I exposed in this video, as well as their changes to the great controversy that I shared in this video. These heavenly warnings were removed to hide the wicked actions of the SDA leaders. Removing them also prevented the people from leaving the church and taking the tithe with them. The fact the church has a 501c3, making them the prophesied preachers of filthy lucre, as well as blind to the prophecy regarding God's command to not join your church with the state, shows Satan has taken this church leadership as his own. One can see why this quote was changed in the 1904 version of the Testimonies, and especially in their newer book published in 1983 during the mass exodus of the church. And by the way, that exodus was the end result of their changing the Seventh-day Adventist statement of faith, as I shared in this video. One can see this 1983 book and all those after it are their way of slowing the exodus of obedient Christians from their ranks. For Sister White to say their actions were taking all sacredness from the office meant the Lord was no longer in the work, and so they had to rip that statement from the pages to prevent the people from leaving the church to follow Christ, who was asked to leave years prior. Worse yet, for her to say they were loading the guns of the enemy and placing them in their hands to be used against the truth was an open rebuke against those in league with the devil and working to help Rome further its work of deception. And so I echo her words when she said these edited books came from Satan's manufactory, and they are in fact hellish in nature. And for those of you that would like to have this original book in hand so as to compare it with the books you receive from the SDA Church, go to vbates.com. However, at present, the site is in the process of being updated, and this pamphlet and a few others won't be posted on the site till mid to late June. Just call the phone number here to order this particular book to see for yourself that, as I stated in previous videos, Sister White knew they were going to change her writings so as to keep the people in apostasy which then assured the apostate leaders would have the tithe they needed to fund their hellish work all the way up till probation closes, and they and all that refuse to follow Christ out of the church are forever lost. Thank you for watching. God bless.